welcome to another draft here on Channel Fireball. Flying solo today, and what do we got here? This is a sort of good first pick. I will not be unhappy to pass a bunch of garbage and take Sword. We are passing Fangor Marauder, Blight Widow, Gruesome Encore, and not a whole lot. I mean, we're sending a pretty heavy green signal because the next two best cards far and away are green. Past that, there's a Phyrexian Rager, an Ichor Wellspring, a card I've not been incredibly impressed with, and a Treasure Mage, which card which I like a lot, though isn't really a high pick. So, long story short, taking the Sword, and we'll see what comes up next. Sword doesn't really even lend itself to necessarily any given archetype. I mean, yeah, it's good with all the white flyers and whatnot, but I mean, the card's so ridiculous. You can put it in almost any deck, and it's going to be awesome. So, I look forward to trying that out. Speaking of almost any deck, geez. We've got Blue Sun Zenith, which is a card I think is pretty sweet. And we've also got a Gopher to Throat, a card which is very sweet, and foil. It's also a Spread the Sickness, and that's basically it. So the question is whether we want to take one of the two black cards, removal spells both, or take Blue Sun Zenith. I've actually had mixed experiences with this. I mean, it's a very good card, but it does cost 6 or 7 mana to really utilize. And at that point, well, I mean, 6 or 7 mana spells are supposed to be pretty good. This doesn't even directly win you the game. It's going to be hard to pass one of these removal spells. So now the question is, which one should I go for? This is more expensive, but it kills anything. This is somewhat limited, but it's a lot cheaper. I'm actually just going to go for the instant. Plus it's foil. I mean, that can't hurt. I understand that the guy to our left is probably Infect at this point with Spread the Sickness and Blightwood or something along those lines, but I'm still going to go for the Throat and go for the Throat again since, I mean, there's a Morbid Plunder, which is sweet, but it's not as good as Go for the Throat. Had I known I was getting past another Go for the Throat, I would have probably taken Spread the Sickness since I'd rather have one of each. But if I just have one, I actually like this just because 2 mana and 5 mana is such a big difference. A 2 mana removal spell is just so much more efficient. And against basically any deck, you're going to have a ton of targets. There's no deck that's all artifact creatures. So, boom. Alright. Well, Morbid Plunder it is. It's not only the best card here, it's also black, which was the only color we know we are for certain. So, I'm going to go ahead and snap that one up. Plus, it gives me a lot of things to do with all my mana. Alrighty. So, this is interesting. We've got Virulent Wound, a fine card. We've got Decimator Web, David Ochoa's Invitational card. It's pretty slow and offers a finisher, but I don't think we need that with what we have so far. We've got Dross Ripper, which is not that great, but a guy to put a sword on. I mean, that's not the worst. And a bunch of off-color mediocre cards. Question really comes down to Virulent Wound and Dross Ripper. And given what we already have, I mean, Virulent Wound's a better card. And it goes much better if we end up being Infect. But Dross Ripper is a guy to put Sword on and get back with Morbid Plunder. So I think I'm just going to go ahead and take the Ripper. Not a whole lot of action here. Plus one thing to note is I don't really expect much Infect Pack 2. So I don't really want to be in Infect per se. We've got a Sky Hunter, but I really don't want to take... Black White is not only bad, it's also like double white Morbid Plunder. Just doesn't go well together. We've got Tangle Mantis, which does work well with Sword of Feast and Famine because it has Trample, but we've, again, passed two good green cards and Spread the Sickness. I don't expect to get a ton of green. Passing Blue Sun Zenith isn't too bad, and I do like Steel Sabotage, so I might actually just take that. Titan Forge is the kind of card I would normally like, but it's too slow even for me, and Razorfield Rhino is not that great. I just don't think I'm going to get enough green in Pack 2 to justify taking Tangle Mantis there because it's not like it's that awesome of a card. Alright, here we've got a nice little nested ghoul to strap a sword onto and get back with Morbid Plunder, and I think it's a pretty easy pick. I mean, I like Steel Sabotage, but nested ghoul we're going to play for sure, because we're definitely black, we're only possibly blue. And it's the exact kind of value guy you want to get back with Morbid Plunder, or force them to block with sword. Both those outcomes seem pretty good to me. Vivisection, a card which I was used to be a lot more impressed with, now I'm, you know, less so. Or another Dross Ripper, so I think I'll be taking the Dross Ripper and passing the rest of this crap. Did you just rip that guy? It feels like I've seen this pack before. It's some sort of, I don't know what the right word is. We've got Spire Serpent, which is not great with Sword. We've got Spin Engine, which is a little better, especially since, you know, you can evade with protection from a black, green, and any creature. It's pretty sweet. Nathosaur is not the pick here. The really question is Spire Serpent or Spin Engine, and I think I'd rather have the Spin Engine. Even if I end up being blue, Spire Serpent isn't necessarily something I'm going to take, and Spin Engine works a lot better with the cards we already have. Same goes for Mirran Spy. I'll just take two Spin Engines, and plus I like being in red if we go to Pack 2 and open Horde Smelter. Pista Strike, not too big of a deal. Now I'll take the Mirran Spy, since Mirran Spy Sword is pretty good. Plus I get to untap all my lands, play a thing, and then untap him. That is a pretty big game. I don't really want my sword crushed. Ooh, I like Oculus too much. It looks like I'm more likely to be blue here than red, which is a horrifying revelation when I open a Horde Smelter. But despite having two Spin Engines, I don't feel firmly tied to red, and I didn't take them over anything too awesome. I mean, Vivisection's fine, but I don't know. In my experience, it's just not the best way to get card advantage. All right, let's see what Scars of Mirrodin has. If you go to Color Sort, I'm assuredly black, and yeah, geez, there's some red cards. All right, well, let's hide these blue cards, because we're picking up a Kuldotha Phoenix here. Yeah, that's definitely going to be the pick. I mean, the next best card is like Embersmith, which if we're going to take a red card, we might as well take the red cards, because they both commit us to pretty heavy red. You don't want to splash Embersmith. So, Phoenix is a beater. Shipping a Cis Bear in every direction. I don't like shipping this Embersmith because it's going to make Pack 3 a little awkward. Let's see if we're going to wheel anything here. They're going to take Cis Bear, Darksteel Axe, Culling Dice, Embersmith. It's 4 plus 2 mirrors is 6 plus Nectarine Sensor. So we might wheel like a Ferrovore or a Drosshopper. Yippee. All right. And I guess the guy to our left didn't get the memo about poison. Jeez, and he took his actual rare, leaving us just the foil rare. Ooh, I do like Lux Cannon. It's kind of slow, but it's certainly good value, and there's some decks that just have a horrific time beating it. We're not really beat down here. We're definitely control here. If you look at our cost sword, we've got random guys, a sword, two Gopher to Throats, and a Morbid Plunder. So I would say we're not necessarily beat down. And even if we weren't to take Lux Cannon, the next best card is like an Iron Mirror and Instill Infection. Plus, again, foil, tiebreaker. So it is the deluxe version, which I'll be taking. All right, well, there's an Embersmith. Our artifacts are a little expensive, but we could pick up some cheap ones. So this seems like a pretty easy pick here. Speaking of cheap artifacts, man, look at all these Cis Bears, passing 10 Cis Bears in the opposite direction. Ooh, so we've got Shatter and we've got Perilous Mirror. I do like a Perilous Mirror. It's good with Embersmith, it's pretty good with Sword of Feast and Famine, it's good with Morbid Plunder. But Shatter is just removal. You know, all these Cis Bears do make me kind of nervous. I think Perilous Mirror might help there. Though we've got double Gopher to Throat for Cis Bear and then Shatter to make up for. Yeah, I'm going to go with the Shatter. I think that's a pretty close pick here, but I don't know. I like having at least two or three ways, if possible, to just kill an artifact because of crap like Lux Cannon and Sword of Feast and Famine. Though I guess we have all the cards that need killing, so... Well, there's some white cards. The first white cards we've seen all draft and heading back in the other direction, which is a reward for the guy to our right who's cutting white. Our pick's pretty obviously Shatter here since don't really need Volshock Replica. And now I wish I took Perilous Mirror over Shatter because just got past three Shatters in a row. Definitely better than Painsmith, even though I already have two. So enough with the Shatters. This time, of course, we're not playing it, but still. Yeah, there's not even a playable card in here, so we're just going to take the Revoke Existence just so people don't get us. Ooh, this is a tough one. Locomotive Coating plus Triple Shatter is pretty nice, and passing it does make him stop our Gopher to Throat pretty effectively, but I think Fume Seeder is going to go well enough with Morbid Plunder and Sword that I'm just going to go ahead and pick that one up. Yeah, there's some white cards, all right. Glimmerpoint Stag and Glinthawk. Someone's getting the hookup. Alright, as expected, we wheeled the crap. Someone took Disperse over Nectarine Sensor. I guess that's not too big of a surprise. Goblin Cavalier is not a card I want to play. Neither is Drosshopper, and neither is Ferrovore. How entertaining. I guess Drosshopper is the most likely to see play, because we've got a sword and it's a 2-drop. All right, flesh allergy and unplayables. We'll take the flesh allergy and then hide it. Yeah, man, it looks like the Perilous Mirror would have been better, though. I don't mind where we are here. We've got a bunch of removal spells, an Embersmith, a sword, and a Lux Cannon, a Morbid Plunder, and a Kuldotha Phoenix, and a Nested Ghoul. So we've got some good top-end finishers, and we've got a bunch of removal. All right, that's not on my watch. I'll just snap that one up, take the black card. What to expect out of pack three? Probably a bunch of black, since we got past double go for the throat and spread the sickness, so it's unlikely the person to our right is black. Didn't see any red pack one, really, so except for like really late spin engines, which is not a signal, so I don't expect a ton of red in pack two. I think, if anything, the guy to our right is like red-white. But a fair amount of black should be good, and man, I mean, we don't need a ton of playables. We've got 16 cards I'd be happy to play. I'd like to pick up a few artifacts, only have six, but if we get like three or four artifacts, I would not be unhappy. So, overall, this draft is going pretty well. Try got a Mending that we're not going to play, or Kak Sunspear Shikari. Alright. The guard our right's definitely white. We don't need to give him any signals. We've passed enough late revokes and Razor Hippogriffs that he can go ahead and take those, and you know, we'll abstain from passing him a really late Sunspear Shikari. Yeah, I'm a skilled drafter. That's a Master Core. And shipping Galvanic Blast, Perilous Mirror, Heavy Arblast, Trinket Mage, Moriak Replica, Snapsail Glider, Contagious Nim. Let's see. There's a possibility we wheel like a Snapsail Glider. We're not going to wheel Blast, Perilous Mirror, Arblast, the cards we actually want. But, I mean, what am I complaining about? I just opened a Master Core. I swear, I don't cherry-pick drafts. I put all the ones up I record. This time I just happened to open Sword of Feast and Famine, Kuldotha Phoenix, Master Core. Only two out of three are Mythic, though, so I was actually kind of running below expectation. All right, the pick here is easy. We just take the fourth Shatter. Oh, wait, that's not the pick at all. the question is whether we want Turn to Slag or Grasp of Darkness, and I think I'd rather have Grasp. I mean, Turn to Slag is pretty sweet, but again, like Spread the Sickness, it costs 5, Grasp costs 2. And because we have these three Shatters, I don't think we're worried about equipment. So I'll be grasping at straws, taking that. And we've got Go for the Throats to kill the large green monsters, Shatter to kill the large artifact ones. So Grasp seems like it fits perfectly. It kills all the things we need to kill at a price that we're willing to pay. Sounds like some sort of advertisement. See, getting anything back? Shatter, the two green guys. We might get a Volshock Replica back, but probably not. We'll see. Jeez, there's some cards here. Definitely Embersmith not the pick here, since we've only got 7 artifacts. But Galvanic Blast most certainly is. So it looks like our prediction of the guy to our right being red-white seems not right. And I say our like anyone else but me had any hand in it. Alright, well, we've got a Barrage Ogre, which is horrible because there's nothing to throw except Mythics. I mean, he should do extra damage when he throws a Mythic. I mean, I have 3 sweet Mythics here. But the alternative, I guess, is a Kuldotha Forgemaster, which is also not exactly optimal. The question is, am I going to be able to pick up some garbage spell bombs, which this deck actually does kind of want. Kuldotha Forgemaster is never going to be activated. I'd rather take Barrage Ogre on the off chance that I pick up some random guys than to take the Forgemaster. This is actually a perfect pack. I cannot complain about getting a mirror here, since it powers up Embersmith and Barrage Ogre and Molotov Master Core. If I had access to green Wall of Tangled, I think would be the pick, but this deck's definitely going to want the mirror. Turn 3 Lux Cannons. This deck's pretty nice. I would say the card quality is high, if I had to describe it in one word. Alright, Barb Battle Gear. This is probably not the deck for it. On the other hand, Fume Spitter is a card I will gladly welcome. I really like that I have Morbid Plunder in this deck, because in a deck full of, you know, one-for-one spells, Morbid Plunder is insane. Not only can I not beat Morbid Plunder, it also is going to be pretty nice getting back, you know, a Fume Spitter and, like, you know, a Spin Engine, just, you know, for more trades. So here, the question is, will I play Liquid Metal Coating? It gives me plenty of ammunition for Barrage Ogre. It pings with Embersmith, and it gives me a target for my 3 Shatters. I guess it can also power up Galvanic Blast. Yeah, I think the odds that I played are greater than the odds that I care about facing an Alpha Tyrannax or a Carrion Call, so I'm going to go ahead and snap that up. Alright, Volshock Replica, that's kind of the card I want here. Seems like that's liquid metal coating not making it. Wow, Moriak replica wield and trinket mage? People, I'd have to go back and look, and Stoke Rebuttals and Snapshot Ladder, but people took some bad cards out of this pack, I can tell you that. Yeah, I'm happy enough with the Moriak replica here. Not going to play the Heartstoker. This is definitely not the deck for Exsanguinate. I'm not trying to race here at all. I'm cutting this liquid metal coating, by the way. I guess of all these cards, I'd least rather play against Alpha Tyrannax. All right, so I have to cut one card out of this because I don't want to play 16 land. I think 17 is fine. I have this. How many artifacts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 10 artifacts, so Embersmith's reasonable. Still wish I took Perilous Mirror over Shatter now, but I would rather have two Shatters than any Perilous Mirror, but I definitely would rather have two Shatters, one Perilous Mirror than three Shatters. And yes, that's me actually complaining about getting too many Shatters. I mean, the first Shatter was good. The second Shatter was pretty decent. The third Shatter was just a gruesome encore. Vanilla Guy, or Artifact Vanilla Guy? I guess we'll go for Artifact Vanilla Guy, though. I'm going to have to cut another card. Not playing Razorfield Thresher. Cacolumen Grigic. I mean, I could cut one of the Fume Spitters, but Fume Spitter seems pretty good. I've actually got to cut two cards here. Don't really want to cut Embersmith either. I mean, I could cut the Sabreclaw Golem. No, I don't even know if that's right. Too many good cards. This is... I mean, Lux Cannon's sweet in this deck. I have no way to proliferate it, but Lux Cannon with our nine removal spell deck... is certainly a pretty good combination. Lux Cannon, kill your guy, kill your guy, kill your guy. Lux Cannon active. Kill your guy. Kaboom. Alright, well, let's get the... Oh, wait, I have a Crush too? Yeah, the Crush is not making it. Even though I had Crush, I still would like the first Shatter over... What's his Mongoose? The Perilous Mirror. Alright, Yep, 25. It's like we countered this already. Alright. Actually, it's... Zoop. I mean, this is a 17 lander. I mean, that seems pretty clear. Well, I guess with an Iron Mirror... And if I take out a 5 drop... I could play 16 land. I've got, like... seven removal spells that cost two or less mana. And I guess Draw Stripper and Masticore are kind of mana intensive, and then Barrage Ogre, Kudotha Phoenix, and Nested Ghoul all cost five mana. Yeah, playing 17 lands is just asking for trouble. I'm gonna cut a Fume Spitter, I think. I'm not cutting any of the spells. And I don't really want to cut an artifact. I think this looks good. Is Barrage Ogre even good? Let's see. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I have 10 artifacts, but I don't really want to throw any of them except Iron Mirror, maybe Volshock Replica. So it's certainly possible that Sabreclaw Golem is better than Barrage Ogre. If I ended up playing the Liquid Metal Coating, then I could see playing the Barrage Ogre, but I really don't want, like, snap playing Liquid Metal Coating. If it comboed with Go for the Throat, that'd be sweet, but it does not combo very well with Go for the Throat at all. Alright, anything I want to cut for a Fume Spitter? I guess if I cut the Sabreclaw Golem, I could put in Fume Spitter, and then also put in something cheap, like a Drosshopper, but then I'm playing Drosshopper over a 17th land, and in a deck this good, that's just probably not a good idea. Yeah, I guess I like this. I mean, Fume Spitter's sweet with Sword just because it's a cheap creature, but I don't know. I've got enough. I have 13 guys to put Sword on and a Morbid Plunder if I run out, so that seems fairly reasonable. I guess 13 guys doesn't really count these two because those two are like probably good enough on their own, so it's really like 11 creatures. One's an Iron Mirror, one's a Fume Spitter. Yeah, that's still fine. It's not like I have to do it right away, and I've got a lot of removal, so... let's see. 9-8 in favor of black, it says. I've got Iron Mirror. So that would be basically 9-9 on a Moriak replica. I've got a triple red and a bunch of single reds, and then double black, double black, double black, and some single blacks. I think my mana is going to be pretty good no matter what. I guess Saber Golem kind of counts. The two spin engines and the Volshock replica, and then the Draw Strippers. So yeah, I've got a bunch of, quote, colorless cards that aren't really. So, I'm either 9-8 in favor of black or 9-8 in favor of red. I think I'm actually 9-8 in favor of red. Just because I want double red for the spin engines just so I can get them through. And triple red is a lot harder than double black. Eight swamps should be enough here. I don't really need Nested Ghoul or Morbid Plunder till a little later, although I guess I would like an early grasp, but I think eight swamps is going to be perfect. All right, let's see how this goes.